Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for tuning in. Today is a highly requested video all about study tips. As many of you guys who follow me on Instagram, 15 Blades, you know that I'm basically what you call a professional student. So after the traditional elementary school, middle school, high school, undergrad, I then went to graduate school and did dental school, and then I did medical school. If you're a little bit confused about why I did dental school and medical school and all this craziness, go ahead and go to my channel. I do have a video about being an oral maxillofacial surgery resident, which is what I am right now. But basically, long story short, I have taken so many different exams, you guys. I mean, countless midterms, finals, standardized tests, board exams. I mean, I've literally taken the MCATs, the DATs, the NBDE dental boards, the USMLEs. I have like literally taken so many different board exams and have just like, oh my gosh. Yes, I'm a professional student, and at this point I've picked up a few tips and tricks here and there in order to study efficiently, study well, and really be able to excel in a lot of different exam types and exam situations and lots of different classes and scenarios. And so I'm going to go ahead and share these tips with you guys, and you know, just keep in mind that everyone has a different style in studying and things that work best for them. When I transitioned from high school to undergrad, I underwent like a huge study change because high school came really, really easy to me. I was valedictorian, I did pretty well, and I didn't have to study a lot. And then when I started UC Berkeley, I was like, oh my God, I must be the dumbest person on earth, because I was getting like 40% on my chem weeder course when I was like surrounded by 1,000 other geniuses, and I was like, oh my God, I don't know what to do. And so I realized I really have to find a different study strategy, and it took a couple of years to be able to really be able to like find what works well for me and be able to incorporate it. So some people are, you know, really visually driven, and you know, there are things that cater to that. So in the medical world, there's things like sketchy micro, where they talk about different, you know, bacterias and microbiology and all of this stuff, and they use images and photographs to be able to teach you that material. And then some people are more audio tuned, and for those people, there's a lot of audiobooks and lots of different things that you can listen to that can help you. And so you have to just kind of find what works best for you and be able to use resources that cater to that. I'm going to give you just kind of like general study tips that I think work well for everyone and work really well for other people that I know that are really, really successful and have done historically really well on a lot of different exams, like good exam takers. This is the type of stuff that they do. So the best part is I only have 3 study tips. That's it. 3 things that you could do and incorporate into your study routine to really help you excel and do well on your exams. The number one study tip seems a little bit obvious, and that is repetition. Repeat, 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 repeat. You hear a difficult concept, you don't know what's going on, you listen to it once, twice, 3 times, and then you repeat it to yourself, you put it on a flashcard. That's like the OG way for repeat information. When information is really difficult at first, it only gets easier when you repeat it. Trust me, you guys, when I went through undergrad, I mean, like, biochemistry was just like a foreign language to me. And then I took it again in dental school, and then I took it again in medical school, and with like the repetition, and when I was studied for it for the USMLE, it just like the concepts just make sense. So repetition, repetition, repetition is really, really key. And obviously the OG way is flashcards. So you know, you put a concept on one side of the paper, and then you put the information on the other side, and you just kind of keep, you know, repeating those concepts. And now we like to save the environment, which is great. And so you can use a lot of free apps that allow you to basically create flashcards online and be able to repeat that information to yourself. So repetition is extremely important. For me personally, it was really, really hard to remember drug names. That was like so difficult for me, because I'm somebody who really needs to understand something to be able to really, you know, really remember it. And so, you know, organic chemistry came easy to me because it was like a pathway, it makes sense. If you understand, you know, the rules, then you can kind of follow it, and it makes sense, so you can kind of remember it. But drug names was like, that didn't make sense. It was just a name. And so it was really hard for me to get through pharmacology, and the only thing that allowed me to do it is repetition. I would just literally put the drug name on one side, what it was used for on the other side, other information that I needed to know, and just kind of repeat exposure. I'd be walking somewhere, I'd have my flash guys, repeat, repeat, repeat. I'd be waiting at the doctor's office for, I don't know, my flu shot, repeat, repeat, repeat. So like, you are constantly exposing to yourself to the same concepts over and over again. And sometimes you might need to listen to it in different ways. So you listen to it from your professors and you, you know, watch the lecture and then you read it in the textbook. And that's also different ways of repeating the same difficult concepts so that you can start understanding it, regurgitating it, and being able to basically kind of repeat that information on the exam. This is also a really good transition to my next study tip. So study tip number two is talk it out, write it out. So that goes hand in hand with repetition, because I think one of the most helpful things is being able to write things out and then talking things out. So when concepts are really, really difficult, being able to break them down and then write them out and then talk them out to other people. So study groups is really effective, especially when it's really difficult concepts or, you know, a lot of mechanisms like physiology or pathology or pathophysiology. Those are really, really difficult concepts, and it's really helpful to be able to talk it out, write it out on a chalkboard. Chalkboard is like ancient. I don't even know who has a chalkboard anymore. I don't know why I even said that. Write it out on a whiteboard or a smart board or an iPad or Apple Smart Pencil. I don't know. It sounds like I'm like a million years old. I'm not, I promise. I don't know why I even said chalkboard, but write it out. Writing out a pathway, writing out the mechanism is really, really important to break down the difficult concepts and say, you know what? I understand how this starts. I understand how this ends. I understand, you know, how food goes from your mouth to your, you know, through your esophagus and then ends up in your stomach. I understand the stomach enzymes. I'm getting a little bit shaky on the GI, you know, on your intestines, you know, what really is secreted, what is not secreted, what happens here, what doesn't happen here. You break it down, then you figure out your weak spots, and then you talk it out with somebody else. If you're not somebody who benefits from study groups, and that's totally fine, that could be your own study strategy, then talk it out with yourself. You know, tons of people who didn't like to study with other people, but would talk it out on their own. And when you talk it out, it actually forces you to make sure that not only are you reading the concept, reading it is one thing, but being able to regurgitate it and talk it out and basically explain it to yourself, even if you're not doing this in a study group, is a whole nother ballgame. And that's how you're really able to test yourself. And that's a perfect transition to my study tip number three. Test yourself. That is so, so, so important, you guys. I mean, that got me through undergrad, dental school, medical school. Test, 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 test. I can't even emphasize this enough. It is really one thing to read the material and think you know it, and it's another thing to be able to answer a question about it. So that's really important. No matter what you're studying, if it's a cardiovascular system and you have to know EKGs, go print a bunch of different EKGs and test yourself and see whether you or not you can read it. Because it's one thing to like really just read a textbook and say, oh, okay, I understand that this amplitude translates to this. But when you see an EKG and you look at it, you might not know how to be able to like apply everything that you've learned in real, you know, test kind of setting. And so it's really important to test it out. And honestly, you can find questions to everything, whether it's Quizlets online that other people have created before you, or whether it's other friends that you sit down and you like test each other. I know there's people that like, even if, you know, practice questions weren't out there, they would sit down and they would take the material and they'd like read the notes and they would kind of like test each other. So they'd like read a fact and turn it into a question and kind of trade off and test each other. So it's super, super important to be able to test yourself, because that's how you ensure that you actually understand the material and that come exam day, you are going to kill it. So that's it, you guys. Those are my top three study tips, and I think if you follow them and incorporate them into whatever study routine that works for you, you can really, really be successful and get through all of those super, super annoying standardized exams and also midterms and all of these different, you know, exam scenarios that you might find yourself in. So again, the three study tips are repetition, write it out, talk it out, and test yourself. Must do, no matter what exam it is that you're taking, you have to incorporate those in your study routine. So that's it, you guys. I hope you found this video helpful. As always, make sure that you subscribe to my channel, like this video, comment below, and if you want to follow me on a daily basis, I post a lot on my Instagram, 15 Blades, and I have my blog, www.15blades.com. Thank you so much for tuning in, and I will see you next time.